Well, that's funny. My voice didn't come back to me. I'll try it again. Hello? Hello? Oh, my goodness! Now my singing voice is gone. My song, it never came back. I can't sing anymore. Hello? Hello? I can't sing. My song went to the mountain and never came back. What will I do? What will I do? Wait. I know. The animals in the forest are all my friends. They'll help me. I'll go off into the woods and ask them. I must find my singing voice, or I'll never be able to sing again.
So Sparky went off into the woods to get some help from his animal friends. The first animal he came to was a bear.
Mr. Bear, have you seen my singing voice anyplace?
The sound of the wolf howling, similar to a seagull cry. They're both sounds that I like a lot, and I think because they evoke such a specific image and environment. For me, the seagull is, of course, like a beach sort of ocean scene. And the wolf is a similar sort of environment. It's often like an outside, expansive environment, like a big space, but it's always nighttime to me for some reason. The seagull and the wolf cry are kind of the same, but one's the daytime version and one's the nighttime version to me.
Oh, well, thanks anyway, Mr. Bear. Guess I'll just have to keep trying.
And poor Sparky went walking on through the woods, wondering if he would ever be able to sing again. As Sparky walked on through the woods, the next animal he met was a big, fat bullfrog sitting by a pond. The frog was singing.
Oh, Fatso, you sing so well. And you know, I like to sing too, but I can't anymore. I sang my song and the echo never came back, and now my song is gone. You know where I could find it?
I particularly like the red velvet one. I think red velvet is not as popular as it should be. It's kind of like a mixture of chocolate and vanilla, you know? But it's red, you know, because the food dyed, and so people don't know it's chocolate and vanilla mixed, I guess. But I
didn't know that till right now.
Yeah.
Mr. Fish, do you know?
I walked up to one pink sugar elephant, asked why wouldn't he speak to me. But he was a factory made pink sugar elephant, given to children for treats after tea.
Well, here was no help, but I have an idea. I'll ask the wise old owl. Mr. Owl, where can I find my...
It's always been a really exciting moment for me, personally, as a music listener. And I feel like whenever I meet someone or talk to someone, it's kind of had this moment where they saw music as being like this thing. And then something happened where they're suddenly like their kind of awareness or consciousness of what music could be or what was even pleasant to them, like the same way that your like taste would develop. But you know, suddenly you understand why you like Brussels sprouts now and you didn't when you were a kid. It's like suddenly there's just this opening of like awareness of what it can be, and to me that's a really exciting thing to watch.
Of course, the old man of the mountain. Why didn't I think of that before? That's where my voice was lost, so he's sure to know. Old man of the mountain, where is my song? I want to sing again.
Get yourself together, man. Move to Philly. Buy a loft. Start a noise band. Get 6 or 7 roommates. Eat hummus with them. Book some gigs. Paint. Smoke clothes. Listen to Animal Collective.
Start some type of salsa company.
Mm-hmm. I'm Brian, I'm a geologist.
Oh, thank you, old man of the mountain. Now I can sing again. Hello.